What's good, YouTube? It's your man, My Hater, with another episode of Muscle and Manhood. Well, I have a topic for today that I think you might find interesting. I'm going to use a case study from an old popular, it's not really that old, maybe a decade old, but for some of you younger guys, it's going to be old. A popular Hollywood film called The Samurai, okay? The Last Samurai. The Last Samurai is a story about a washed up cavalry soldier, American cavalry soldier, who, you know, went to war against a lot of the Native Americans and Little Big Horn and some other wars, and was basically a bit of a celebrity of a soldier. He was a hero. And he was grieving his experience because he saw things that no human being should see in battle. And he fought for reasons that he didn't believe in. Now, please pay attention to how I'm setting this up, because I'm hoping that I'm able to mesh these ideas together. Sometimes my ideas they get a little abstract, and I want to keep them concrete. So we have this character who's played by Tom Cruise, charismatic character who is a war hero in his own right. One of his commanding officers recruits him to do warfare, basically function as a mercenary, to come to Japan or go to Japan and to waylay samurai, Japanese samurai, whom the emperor, under the guidance of his counselors, are trying to ostracize and extract so that they can move forward with their embracing of Western values. That was a mouthful. That's the best I can summarize the film. Basically, it's a war hero who, you know, regrets what he's been through and what he's seen and what he's done. He's recruited to go to Japan to kill Japanese. Okay, Japanese samurai. And the samurai were essentially, you know, the soldiers of Japan up until they began to embrace Western values and use the artillery and guns and whatnot that Western civilization was bringing into that modern age. So now, in the duration, while he's in Japan, and he confronts the samurai for the first time, I'm not going to tell you the whole story. You can see the film if you haven't seen it, and you'll enjoy it more if I don't tell you all of it. But the important part that I'm trying to get across today is the character, the personality, and the complexity of this character that Tom Cruise is playing. He was, by an American standard, an alpha male. He's a soldier, tough, you know, ornery, smart ass, smart, you know, strategic, skilled in warfare. He was a badass. Now, what I'm about to say may offend some people. I don't mean to offend anyone, especially soldiers and people who go to war. That's some serious business. But in the film, he had poor guidance, and lots of soldiers get poor leadership. They are fighting for causes that they truly don't believe in, but they do it out of obedience. Now, I want you to think about that in the context of men going their own way. Being blindly obedient or being obedient for the sake of hierarchy, to the degree that you kill people, can have a negative psychological effect on you. Okay? So put a pin in that, because that's going to be relevant to how I kind of summarize all of this. So while he's there and he confronts the samurai for the first time with an unprepared group of soldiers who are just learning how to use these guns, these rifles, he falls into the hands of the enemy and he kills one of the leaders. They take him captive in the mountains to where they live so that they can study the Japanese samurai, so that they can study this white man from America who's come to suppress them. While he's there, now listen to this, he's put in a household of the man who he killed. He's living with his wife, his son, and I believe his brother. And that was at the command of basically the village chief. Okay, and a village leader. While he's there, a transformation occurs. He begins to observe the way of life of these other people to the degree that he has a disdain for his own culture and the way we, us Americans, as it were, go about war. Now, I'm not making a value judgment. I'm telling you what the movie says. And he learns their ways over the course of, you know, a season. I guess he's there through the winter. And he embraces their ways. And he comes to love these people. Their simplicity of life and the way that they cherish life and take great pains to attention to detail. So here's what happens that's very interesting to me. The wife comes to love him too. There's not a love scene or anything, but there is a scene where it's communicated that they love one another. And she's able to set aside her hatred of him, and he's able to set aside his hatred of himself. His hatred of his countrymen, his hatred of his commanding officer. Well, he didn't put that away, really. But what I want to get across to you is this. In my opinion, he was a pseudo alpha whenever he was an American soldier, because he was stuck. Now, and again, I'm going to say this. Let me get this out. It wasn't his fault. He did what he was told to do. He had regrets. But he had regrets. If he could do it all over again, he wouldn't have did it. Are you following what I'm saying? See, there are guys out there who they boast about, I'm alpha. I never been played by a woman. I've never this. I've never that. I've never, whatever. Good for you. But some of us have, and some of us have regrets. If we could go back, we'd do it over again. But some of us are better men for it. See, because he went through all that, and then he fell into another cultural context where he can compare and contrast, he grew. He had a greater appreciation for life. He had a greater appreciation for what one might call a clean kill, what one might call a being in balance with nature. Now, I'm not making a value judgment. I'm telling you what I derived from the film. But the point I'm not trying to criticize guns or none of that. That's for another video. If you're interested in that, ask me. I'll tell you what my opinion is. But for the sake of this case study, I want you to get this point. At the end of the film, he had a purpose and he had a greater sense of self. He was at peace and at ease. He didn't feel like he was doing anything that was in contradiction to his soul. Soul meaning mind and emotions. That's what your soul is. Your soul is a combination of your mind and your emotions. Okay? It's the conversation that happens between your heart, your head, and your stomach. Yeah, that's your soul. So, his soul was restored, and he was prepared to die on a battlefield to defend what was once his enemy. Now, can you see that happening for MGTOW? Can you see that happening for a man in MGTOW? Isn't it possible that there's a lot of guys out there in MGTOW who are hurting, they're regretful, they're remorseful, and as such, they are lashing out at others and to themselves. They hate themselves. They have self-loathing. So what do? They project it like vomit onto other people. And I don't know if you've ever seen, you know, like a spoof of this in a movie, but where one person vomits on the person and that person gets sick from it and they vomit on another person and then that person gets sick from it and they vomit on another. Next thing you know, it's like, you know, Chunky Soup City. Everybody's vomiting on everyone because they're sickened by being vomited upon. Well, that was Tom Cruise's situation. He was sick with grief and remorse and resentment. And he drowned himself in a bottle. Now, how many men out there are doing these kinds of things? They're being self-destructive because they haven't found their purpose. And they haven't taken the time out to change their environment. See, you must change your environment sometime when you've been abused. Don't stay in that house. Sell that damn house. When your marriage broke up and it almost destroyed you, you need to move. You know, you need a new environment because that environment sets up triggers. Leave that city. Stop hanging out at the same clubs, whatever. Whatever you need to do to change the context, you need to do that so that you can reflect and heal and not get drawn back into the hurt. This is just a suggestion. This is what I did. You know, I moved to Costa Rica. So, at the end of the film, you know, he went and he gave the sword of the samurai leader to the emperor, said his piece and whatnot. But what I really found most remarkable about the film was not even that. It was how the masculinity of the men around this female, the wife that of the samurai that got killed, it was incredible. I mean, I don't know a guy who likes feminine women that wouldn't have been attracted to this female character because she was so delicate and feminine in the exact definition of the term. I mean, she had self-control. She that was attractive and rare. She had she was demure. She was soft-spoken and not loud and rude. She was thoughtful and patient. Man, she had all these characters. And yes, it's just a movie, but wow, you know? Incredible character study. And see, this aspect of feminism is not celebrated in our culture. And men are angry about that. And when we see films like that, men want to run off to these exotic places to be with women of other cultures so that they can find peace. But the fail in all of this is this, is that these are our mothers, our sisters, our nieces, our nephews. But these are the women and girls in our lives. We're part of that conversation. If we abandon that, what are we saying? You know, men who get really angry with women and just hate women, what are you saying to your daughter? There has to be a place where we can do that same thing that this character in the movie did, where we can stop, change our environment, get a chance to reflect, and then be whole again, you know, and live our lives in a different way, a less complicated way, a way that's much more closer to nature, in the natural order of things, the way our Creator designed them. Now, this is just my point of view, but I think that when men become more masculine in their center, it frees women to lay down their defenses, and they are more free to express their femininity. You have to understand that women hate each other. Women are more critical of one another than men will ever be of women. They bring a lot of the pressure on themselves, and you get a great deal of pressure coming from feminist groups to make women who have more traditional values be much more masculine in their ambitions. So you have women who are super career oriented because they started that way when they were this tall, you know, this high. And now they're young adults and they're chasing this freedom and this independence that they were told would give their life meaning and purpose. Whenever their meaning and purpose is truly to be found in a loving relationship with a man who is her covering, so that she can be the greatest expression of her feminine self. American women aren't being given that opportunity because of all the social constraints and programs that are conditioning them and the men to produce masculine women who are totally out of sync with their selves. And that's where all the resentment and anxiety and a bunch of it comes from. So this is just some food for thought for the men out there who give a shit. You know, some of you, I could talk to them blue in the face. What I'm saying won't make any sense. Some of you, you're angry as hell, but you'll be like, wow, maybe, yeah, maybe. I'll give that some consideration. But just notice that the woman in the film, The Last Samurai, a lot of MGTOW, they're the kind of guys that get on a ship and go to Japan looking for a woman like that. She's a woman. Are you really going your own way whenever you're transverse 3, 5, 10,000 miles to be with a stereotype from a movie? You will have no idea how many men move to foreign countries looking for a stereotype that they've seen in a film. And sometimes they find a stereotype there because they're waiting to take prey. Because a lot of them are whores, and they'll give that fantasy to men who's seeking it so desperately. The truth of the matter is that women are pretty much the same all over the world. It's just that our culture has become so materialistic and so artificial that we're just all kind of out of touch with ourselves. And as a result, we're seeing this pushback. And it is what it is, guys. It is what it is. So, you know, I hope you got something out of this video. If you have any ideas about it, please leave the comments below. Again, thanks for my new subscribers. I don't know if I said that at the beginning of the video or not, but thank you. I got a bunch of new subscribers. I really appreciate the support and the interest. If you have a topic that you'd like for me to cover, you leave that down below too. I'm going to eventually put give you guys an email address if you want any you want me to answer any personal questions or do any coaching. So let me know what you think down below. Like, share, subscribe, and always, always, always be a man.